Hey guys, Weeby News here, and today I'll actually be covering some news related to Danganronpa. I know it's been a while, but I felt like this was really important. So basically, it's been confirmed now that Kazutaka Kadaka has left from his position at Spike Chunsoft to found a new gaming company called 2Kyo Games, alongside many other reputable creators from both Danganronpa and the Zero Escape series, these including Kotaro Uchikoshi, who is actually the creator of the Zero Escape series, who will be on the team as a director slash scenario writer. Alongside him, there will be Masafumi Takeda, who also worked on the Danganronpa series, as well as 100 Sleeping Princes and the Kingdom of Dreams. He'll be on as a composer and arranger. Ryuki Matsuzaki will also be on the team. He was one of the illustrators slash character designers for Danganronpa, and he also worked on Fate Grand Order. On this team, he'll be a character designer and illustrator. Shimadori Ryu will also be on the team. He also worked on Danganronpa and Fate Grand Order, and he'll be on as an illustrator and character designer as well. Takumi Nazukawa, who worked on Ever 14 and Root Double, will be on as a scenario writer and director. And finally, Yoichiro Koizumi, who worked on Break Kimikore and Ultra Despair Hagakure, will be on as a novelist and scenario writer. Four concepts have already been revealed by the company in a live stream that I'll link below, but unfortunately the stream hasn't been translated yet, so just keep that in mind if you're going to check it out. But basically, the first concept is a collaboration between Kadaka, the Danganronpa creator, and Uchikoshi, the creator of the Zero Escape trilogy. Jimatsu described it as Limit X Despair. Furthermore, Jinjo Jess, a translator on Tumblr, stated that were promised despair taken to the limit from the game. Also that the kanji in the right shows that it might be named Miyako or Capital City. Regarding production, a Polygon article states that it's the highest priority at the studio right now, and the article also mentioned that the genre of the game hasn't been specified yet, but expect several teens entangled with murderous spirits in a fantasy world. The second is an anime series in which Kadaka will be the writer for, and Ryuki Matsuzaki will do the illustrations for. The general and vague concept given out so far is just that everyone is a villain. The anime is a collaboration with Studio Pierrot, and it's said that they will depict the image of action films from the 1990s, such as Pulp Fiction and The Professional through it. The third project is a game again, and is said to be a children's death game by children for children, an action-adventure game by Kadaka as the general manager, Uchikoshi as a scenario writer, and Nakazawa as a director. The concept art drawn by Take, who is an illustrator known for Tawagoto, represents school children playing a death game. It is said to be very shocking. The final project is a Spike Chunsoft and 2Kyo Games collaboration. It's described as a dark fantasy-esque mystery. Jimatsu states, Kadaka actually started this project before his retirement of Spike Chunsoft. We imagine a kind of cyberpunk world from this art. Kamatsuzaki designs the characters, Shimadori Ryu designs the background, and Takeda directs the sound. As for what all this means about the future of Danganronpa, I'm not really sure, honestly. It seems kind of bleak at the moment though, not gonna lie. At the very least, I think it'll probably go on hiatus for a while. Kadaka did state that if 2Kyo was successful, he might return to the Danganronpa franchise and make something new, but that would likely be a while from now. But on the bright side, since one of their projects is a collaboration with Spike Chunsoft, and he said that quote that I just mentioned, it does seem like the possibility of him working on a new Danganronpa game isn't totally dead. He also stated a while back in an interview that he would be interested in seeing somebody else's take on a Danganronpa type game, but I'm not 100% sure if he might have changed his mind on that since doing this other interview that's more recent. He is somewhat more interested in returning to Danganronpa now than he was then. And one last thing I do want to mention regarding new Danganronpa games is something I'm kind of confused on. A while back, there was speculation that there was a new Danganronpa game in production, since there was a job post for a new Danganronpa installment. That was almost a year ago though, and I haven't heard anything since, so I'm unsure if that project got canceled or put on hiatus, or if Kadaka is just not going to play a big role in it and it's still in production. But I'll try to keep you guys posted on that if I hear anything else on it. If any of you guys know more on that as well, please let me know. I haven't been able to find anything. As for my personal opinion, I'm super duper excited to see what these games have in store for us. I'm especially interested in the Kadaka Uchikoshi collaboration, even though I haven't actually gotten that far in 999 yet. Just from the parts that I have played, I can tell this collaboration has like major potential, especially since there is so many shared fans between Danganronpa and Zero Escape. I am a little bit sad that Danganronpa might be over, but I'd way rather it end here than it get dragged out to the point that it's not enjoyable anymore. And I especially don't want Kadaka working on a game that he's not passionate about anymore, and he really just does not seem to be all that interested in working on Danganronpa at the moment. I think one of the reasons why I like Danganronpa so much is because I can tell Kadaka is working on a game that he's proud of, and that he's working on a game that he himself would enjoy, that he's not making it for money or anything along those lines. So I feel like if he was just pumping out Danganronpa games for money because they're successful now, the games probably wouldn't end up being very good, and I'd much rather see him work on a new project that he can be proud of and see how that goes. I do kind of like the idea of somebody else putting their take on a Danganronpa killing game, just because I really do enjoy the class trials and the whole setup of the killing game. But if these games are just as good as Danganronpa, honestly, I think I'll be more than satisfied. Also, I saw in another article that the director of Persona 5 stated that he was actually a bit envious of Kodaka and this new company and the projects that Kodaka's working on right now. And that just gets me even more hyped for these games, hearing that from him. But yeah, I just wanted to let you guys know about this update. I will still be making videos on Danganronpa for as long as you guys enjoy them. I'll also be covering Danganronpa fan projects like Danganronpa Kill Cure, as well as any others you guys might be interested in, which I sort of have like a list now that you guys recommended from that video. I also plan on covering any news for these games and hopefully being able to make analysis videos on them or let's play videos or streaming them whenever they do come out, and hopefully, fingers crossed, to get localized. I also would like to make some videos on Zenki Zero, Spike's other new project as well, once it gets a Western release date. And just in general, like I said in the other videos, I'd like to make some analysis videos outside of Danganronpa. There's a few I already have in mind, some from other video games and some even from anime, so I'll keep you guys posted on that. But anyways, let me know what you guys think about this news. Are you hyped for the new games? Or are you just kind of sad that Danganronpa might be over? Also, be sure to let me know what game you're most interested in if you are hyped. Like I said, I think I'm most interested in the first game, just because I think Kodaka Ichikoshi collaboration could be very, very cool. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you real soon.